Okay, girls, let's start making a revision of the vocabulary we learned in the last class. Well, in the last class, we were talking about some new vocabulary, no? These words. Let's make a revision, okay? What it means, take part? ¿Qué es take part? Maribel, good evening, welcome.
Good evening.
¿Qué significaba take part in Spanish? Or in English, if you know. Take part. Ese es el otro, ese es el otro. Take part means participate. Take part es que vas a participar en una competencia, ¿no? Pero en vez de decir I am going to participate, dices I'm going to take part. Take part, ¿ok? Take place significa que va a suceder, o sea, happen. The verb happen. Take place. For example, ¿no? I would say this Sunday is going to be a concert, a rock concert. This concert will take place here in Huancayo we have, for example, the Mariscal Castillo Stadium. So the concert will take place in this stadium. ¿Ve? Sucederá el evento en el estadio. That is take place. ¿Qué significaba beat? What is beat? Ganar, very good. Vencer, ¿no? Ganar, good. Workout, what is workout? Workout is a hacer ejercicio, yes. Exercise. I usually work out in the mornings, you see? Workout is when you make exercise. Okay, also we learned in the last class these words. Although, however, because of, that's why, besides, first of all, in addition, as a result, but not least, and for this reason. Estas palabras se conocen como linkers, ¿ok? Linkers. Although, ¿qué significaba although en Spanish? For example, although I am not tall, I'm going to play a basketball game this Saturday. Aunque, very good. Aunque significa, yeah? Remember, although. However, what is however? Sin embargo, good. Because ya conoces, es muy conocido. Porque. Because of es. Ajá, por lo cual, por lo tanto, ¿no? That's why. Por ese motivo, ¿no? Por eso. Besides es parecido a in additions. Además. Besides. Last but not least. Ajá. Por último, pero no menos importante, eso significa. Okay, let's put this, let's work with this, okay? Look at here, please. Yeah, we have here a sentence. Tell me which is the correct option. Sin embargo, la lluvia, however significa sin embargo. Sin embargo, la lluvia, nosotros todavía fuimos al parque. No les enseñé despite. Despite significa a pesar de. Despite the rain, a pesar de la lluvia, ¿no? Despite the rain, we will went to the park. A pesar de la lluvia, fuimos al parque. Todavía fuimos al parque. ¿Ya? Despite también se utiliza. Okay, other. Tell me. Although, however, or despite. Although very good. Aunque estaba lloviendo, ¿no? Good. The next, please tell me. It was raining. We still went to the park. Excellent. However, estaba lloviendo. Sin embargo, todavía fuimos al parque. ¿Sí? Ya, yeah, the next. Yeah. Oh, despite no, although. Aunque era costoso. John bought the watch. Compró el reloj. Aunque era costoso. Si yo traduzco como aunque era costoso, a pesar que era costoso, podría ser también, ¿no? Despite. But this, I think better is although. Yeah, the next. John bought the watch. Aquí sí es, ajá, aquí sí es despite. Oh. What happened? Let's see. Although it was expensive, John bought the watch. John bought the watch, although it was expensive. Yeah, well, let's see. The next, please. She went for a long walk. Yeah, despite, a pesar de sentirse cansado, ¿no? Feeling tired. She went for a long walk. However, si te fijas bien, bueno, al final te digo, ya, yeah? Let's see. The next. The restaurant has a good reputation. Although, however, ahora les explico por qué. Alas, tell me. Yeah, good. Well, en however siempre vamos a usar signos de puntuación, ¿ya? Esa es una regla gramatical. However, después de however, siempre va a haber una coma. Siempre. ¿Ok? Always. Using however, coma. ¿A qué río te pasa? However, coma. Always is that, that is the rule. With solo con however. ¿Ok? ¿Ve? However, coma, the food was terrible yesterday. Con los demás va a depender de del orden de la oración. Como vimos, se puede pasar. O sea, la palabra despite, o en este caso, however, puede estar al inicio, al medio o al final. Va a depender de qué queremos decir, ¿no? Como aquí. En el 4 and 5, ¿no? Although aparece al inicio. Although it was expensive, comma, John bought the watch. ¿Ve? Si lo cambio de posición, igual. John bought the watch, although it was expensive. Solo que en este caso no es necesario la coma. Although. Let's practice with another link, okay? This other link is for you. This. Solo vamos a practicar dos. Although and however. Okay? Although and however. For example, si te fijas bien con la palabra although, como te dije, puede ir al inicio. Although the weather is bad, I love London. O puede ser como aquí en el segundo ejemplo. I love London. Although the weather is bad. ¿Sí? We change the position. The only difference is the comma. Although the weather is bad, comma, I love London. I love London, although the weather is bad. Yeah, the second. However, we know that however is sin embargo, ¿no? The same. Look, I love London, period. ¿Ve? Esta regla siempre recuérdate, ¿ve? Period. However, coma, the weather is bad. The other is I love London. The weather, coma, however, coma, is bad. And the last. I love London. Period. The weather is bad. However. Okay. Only you are going to complete these sentences using however or although. Okay. Only these two words. Yeah. For example, let's work with the one. With the first. What do you think is however or although? Yes, es although. ¿Por qué although no utiliza comas ni puntos? No, no es necesario. Although it was raining, aunque estaba lloviendo, we still went to the park. Se parece al juego que hicimos hace rato, porque son casi las mismas oraciones. Tú. It was raining. Yeah, good. However, we still went to the park. You see? One more, okay? The rest is for you. We still went to the park. You see? We changed the position, you see? You see? It's correct. Do the same, okay? Read a sentence and tell me, please, if is it although or however. Teacher, ¿por qué no ponemos however ahí? Porque however siempre va a utilizar, como le dije, puntuación. Siempre. Okay? I'm going to give you this link, please. When you finish, share your screen. Remember, although significa aunque. And however, sin embargo. Please go to the chat. Open that link, okay? Try to understand the situation, no? If in your opinion it's necessary to translate please the expression. And then you put, no? With aunque, it's this, and however, no? Sin embargo, and you try to do that. Then you share your screen, okay? Share, please, Maribel. Yes, that's good. Good job, Maribel. Thank you. It's good. Susana Reina, did you finish? Yeah, we are going. Let's see. Susana, Reina, 2 minutes more, okay, to finish. Then we are going to continue with the grammar. Okay, Reina, you send me, let's see. Oh, that's good. 9 points is good. Okay, let's continue with the grammar, okay? Okay, my friends, before we continue with activities, we have to learn the grammar, okay? Because in the objective in this lesson is to work with express possibility, okay? To express possibility, we use some modal verbs. What modal? Could. It could happen to anyone. Okay? Podría pasarle a cualquiera. No? It could happen to anyone. And also, we are going to talk about how to refer to conditions and the results. Well, also, we use in the first conditional, we learn the cause, no? If I study English, the consequence, if I study English, I will travel to the USA. That is the consequence. The same we are going to work with modals in the second part. You see? If you are so good, then I might not play. The same is an It's a conditional. También se puede usar condicionales con modales, con can, may, might, could, ¿ok? En vez del futuro, como habíamos visto. Nosotros lo hemos visto con futuro, ¿no? Pero podemos usar en vez de eso, también es posible usarlo con can, could, may y might. So, let's start with the grammar. In English, when you want to talk about possibility, you have to use these three words: may, might, could. Okay? May es puede. Puede, okay? Might es podría y could también significa podría. The modal verbs may, might, could are followed by an infinitive without to. O sea, estos modales se utilizan con un verbo directamente, sin ponerle nada al medio. ¿Ya? Es como el verbo can. I can play soccer. I can swim. I can speak English. ¿Ve? Lo mismo puedes usar estos modales. I might travel to La Merced this Saturday. ¿Ve? Puede que viaje a La Merced. También puedo decir, usando might, I might travel to La Merced this Saturday. ¿Ve? Are the same in all persons in the singular and plural. Yeah? Is it the same? Do not form the questions and negative form with an auxiliary with verb to. No usamos el do, sino su forma negativa, ¿no? ¿Cuál es su forma negativa? May not, might not, o couldn't. We use to express possibility in the present, future. We may, we might, we could go to the amusement park next week. ¿Ok? Para que entiendas un poquito mejor. Teacher, ¿y cuál es la diferencia de los tres? Tiene que ver con esto. Look. Como las tres funcionan para hablar de posibilidades, vamos a usar may, la primera, cuando lo que tú vas a decir, la idea que tú quieres comunicar, es más probable que pase. O sea, un 80, 90%, casi 100% de que pueda pasar. May. Si es que es menos probable que pase, vas a utilizar might. Y menos todavía, could. ¿Ok? Es menos probable que pase. Yeah, let's see. Let's work with some verbs, ¿ok? Ahora vamos a intentar practicar esto. Yeah, look. She has gray hair. She may be old. She might be old. She could be old. ¿Cuál creen que sea la respuesta? She has got gray hair. No, her, the hair is not black, is gray. So, she tell me please, my, oh sorry, may, my or could. Tell me. Gears. Dígame cualquiera, así vamos aprendiendo. Así fallemos, no hay problema. She has gray hair. She might be old. ¿Sí? Es más probable que sea una persona mayor si tiene el cabello plomo. ¿No? Gray. Yeah, the next. You have very dark circles under your eyes. So you might, may, or must feel tired. Yeah, let's see. Good. Es más probable que estés cansado, ¿no? Estás con ojeras. The next. He left an hour early. Must significa debe llegar tarde. Él debe llegar tarde. Salió una hora antes. No creo que pueda llegar. No es probable que llegue tarde. Yes. Recuérdate que could es el que tiene menos probabilidad de que llegue tarde, ¿no? El que menos posibilidad es could. Es menos probable que llegue tarde. ¿Por qué? Porque salió hace una hora. Una hora antes de la reunión. O sea, es bastante tiempo. Si yo digo might, este de acá sería muy probable que llegue tarde. Si salió a tiempo, por ejemplo. Un poquito más. Yeah, the next. My mother not go to the party. She's feeling sick. Only might. Might not go to the party. She's feeling sick. ¿No? Está sintiéndose mal. No es que esté mal, se siente mal. Feeling sick. Yeah, the next. George missed a lot of classes. This student, the student George, missed a lot of classes. So he. Failed the course. ¿Desaprobará el curso? ¿Con qué posibilidad? Could. Might. Dice, se perdió muchas clases. Muy probable es que sí desapruebe. You just ate a sandwich. You just ate a sandwich, ¿eh? Ya comiste un sandwich, ¿eh? So, you. Yes. Si ya comiste, es menos probable. Muy poco probable que estés hambriento todavía. Ok, yo sé que es un poquito complicado porque en castellano usamos solo una forma, ¿no? De decir probable. Creo que, no soy profesor de comunicación, pero sí hay diferencia entre posible y probable. ¿No? Es algo parecido en inglés, con estas palabras, con el modal. Ok. Recuerden esa tablita, esta de acá, ¿no? May es mucho más probable que pase. Hay más posibilidades. Might, un poco menos, might. Y could, pues es mucho menos probable. Could también se utiliza para hablar del pasado. O sea, hace referencia al pasado en probabilidades. Los otros dos no. Los otros dos es solo para presente o futuro. Pero could es el único que puede hablar del pasado. Y a ver. Let's match these ideas, okay? Tell me. For example, the first. Look. I am afraid of dogs because. What do you think is the complement for this idea? I am afraid of dogs because. What could be the right option? Tell me. She may drown, they could fall and crash. He might tell me and that I have terrible illness. They might bite me. Some of them could jump off me. What do you think? Because some of them could jump off me. Alguno de ellos podría saltar encima mío. Pero su miedo es infundado, ¿no? Es muy poco probable que un perro salte encima tuyo. Es muy poco, por eso utiliza could. Yeah, the next. I don't like spiders because. Because they might beat me. Ah, she might drown, podría ahogarse. Drown es ahogarse. They might bite me. O sea, podrían morderme. I don't like spiders because they might bite me. Paola never goes on swimming. Never goes swimming. O sea, nunca va a nadar. Because. Yes, because she may drown. Se podría ahogar. That's why she never goes swimming. See? Maybe she doesn't know how to swim. That's why she never goes swimming. I don't like flying on planes because the planes, airplanes. I don't like traveling. Yes, volar. Because the airplanes could fly or crash. Podrían caerse o chocarse, pero es muy poco probable, por eso lo hice con could. Hay bajas probabilidades de que pase eso. De un airplane fall or crash, ¿no? It's more probably that you have a car accident instead of an airplane accident. And finally, I worry about going to the doctor because illness. Very good. I'm worried about going to the doctor. That is the right option. Now, tell me sentence, okay? Solo vas a ayudarme a formar las oraciones. We're using the models, okay? In the activity D. Oh, sorry, E. What could be the sentence? Look at these keywords. What could be the sentence? I como digo, podría cocinar. I could cook for I could cook dinner. I could cook dinner for your friends. Yes, I could cook dinner for your friends. ¿Sí? Podría cocinar para tus amigos, ¿no? Podría hacer la cena para tus amigos. Pero si alguien te dice eso, es que muy probablemente no lo va a hacer, porque could es muy bajo. Si te dice I might cook dinner for your friends. Es un poquito más. Si te dice I may, el de acá arriba, may, es muy seguro que lo va a hacer. ¿Cómo sería 100% seguro? Porque eso son posibilidades. 100% seguro sería I will cook. Cocinaré la cena para tus amigos. ¿Eh? Ese es el 100% seguro. I will cook. Sí. Menos de eso, I might cook. I may cook, I might cook, I could cook. Menos, ¿ve? Y no cocinaré, I won't. Won't. I won't cook the dinner. I won't cook dinner for your friends. Ok, tú, tell me. Yeah, very good, Julia and very good, Julia and I. Antes de go tenemos que usar el modal. ¿Cuál es el verbo modal? The modal. What? May, okay? In this case, may. Julia and I may go. Tell me, may go. To the movies. Falta una palabra. To the movies. Yes. Julia and I may go to the movie tonight. Si te dicen may, significa que es muy probable de que va a ir. Pero si te dijera Julian I could go, es muy poco probable, ¿no? Maybe she says yes, or maybe she's busy, maybe she has other plans, you see? It depends. Yeah, the next, please. Tell me the next sentence. We. Yeah. We might. Yeah, but eso va al final. We might not have time to go shopping. Yes, we might not have time to go shopping. See, it's the same. Might. This is 50-50, ¿no? Puede que no tenga tiempo para ir de compras. O sea, tampoco es como te digo, 50-50. It's not sure, but also it's not all impossible. It's 50-50. Yeah, not sentence four. Tell me, please. Yeah, this. Yeah, this book. May interesting, no, may not be may not to be this book may not be interesting. Yes. Oh, everyone else is missing, no? Okay, so not be interesting to everyone. Este libro no puede ser interesante para todos. Everyone. See, it's more probably, no? Maybe, I don't know. It talks about maybe it's a kind of drama book, something like that. Yeah, the next. Yeah, careless. It's okay. Careless. Careless driving, okay? O sea, manejar sin cuidado. Careless driving. Yeah, may. Yes, may cause. Serious. Yes. You see? Careless driving may cause serious accident. Aquí utilizamos may porque muy probablemente es que pase eso, ¿no? Si tú manejas cuidadosamente, es muy probable de que hagas accidentes serios, graves. Ok. This book may not the same, ¿no? It means that this book is not good. Maybe the author is not well known, or the story that wants to show is not interesting. Maybe it's boring, no? That's why I say may. Here is 50-50, as I told you, no? Here is more probably that Julie and I go to the cinema. It's more probably 70 or 80%. And this is the same, no? It's less probably that I cook dinner for your friends. This is probability in English, okay? Yeah, let's see. Let's continue, okay? One more, one activity more. Let's see. Now we are going to assess here. Complete this idea. John has not studied a lot. What could be the consequence for this? Write sentences using may, might, or could, and the phrases. Let's use these ideas. Take up, tennis, travel to San Juan, no, travel, help you buy bigger one. Buy a bigger one means comprar, no, comprar algo más grande. O fail the test, fail a test. Okay. Ya habíamos visto verbos con take, ¿no? ¿Qué creen que significa take up? Vimos take part, take place, take advantage of, ¿no? ¿Qué creen que significa take up? Teacher, take up. No lo tomen literalmente. Cuando lo tomas literalmente, el problema es que no siempre es así. Take up means start, begin. ¿Ok? Es empezar. Otro sinónimo para empezar es take up. Otra palabra, start. Otra, begin. Solo que como te dije, ¿no? Si utilizas take up, suenas más con un nivel de inglés mejor, ¿no? Que decir, I start my new English course this Monday. But if you says, I took up my new English course this Monday, you sounds like you speak a better English, no? Okay? So, tell me please, let's complete these ideas, okay? Use these words. For example, we says, John has not studied a lot. So, he... Let's use might, porque nos dan might. He might take up tennis. He might travel to San Juan. He might help you. He might buy bigger one. He might fail the test. What do you think? Yes. He might fail the test. Este es probablemente que falle el examen. 50-50, this is might. 50-50. John has not studied a lot. Yeah, the next. This house is very small for us. The house is very small. We could... What do you think? We could... Yeah, buy a bigger one, no? Bigger one means, refers to the house, no? A bigger one house. Let's, is that, okay? We could buy a bigger one. Yeah, for the next. I like to start a new sport. Yeah, I may. Take up a tennis lesson, okay? Could be a tennis lesson. Okay? Puede que inicie una clase de tenis. O me incluye un take up. Tennis lesson or join to a tennis club, no, maybe. Okay, but it's good. Take up. For the next. I have 1 week off work. ¿Qué crees que significa 1 week off? One week off work. libre, ¿no? De trabajo libre, o sea, holiday, vacation. That is, I have 1 week off work. I could. Yes. I could travel to San Juan. Podría viajar a San Juan, ¿no? And to finish, ask Jenny about your problem. O sea, cuéntale a Jenny tu problema. She might ask Jenny about your problem. She might. Ella podría. Yeah, she might help you. Good. Recuérdense que el might, could y may, el verbo no se modifica, ¿ya? No se modifica. Teacher, pero estamos usando he. No, no es necesario modificar. Es como el verbo can. Y cuando yo digo he can play tennis, no se dice he can plays tennis. Con los verbos modales pasa eso. No, no aplica las reglas de aumentar la S. Teacher, pero está en presente. No. Con los verbos modales no, no funciona eso. Lo mismo que con estos. Might, could, may. ¿Ya? Eso es lo que decía la gramática. You see? Please, open your microphones, okay? Open your microphone. Let's finish. Only repeat, okay? Only repeat. He might fail the test. Open please your microphones. Repeat. Fail the test. Okay, this is might, and remember, might. We could buy a bigger one. I may take up tennis lesson. I could travel to San Juan. She might help you. Might, okay? Repeat, please. May. Might. Could. Could. Okay. This is the possibilities. When we talk about possibilities, we use may, might, or could. También lo vamos a usar, como hemos visto, más adelante en condicionales, okay? In conditionals. Ok, te voy a volver a enviar este texto de acá, esta práctica, porque acá abajo tienes algunas palabras, ¿ve? Ejercicios. Pero lo mismo que hemos hecho, ¿no? For example, I don't know if the science fiction movie is out this week. Tengo que usar could. The science fiction movie could be out this week. Podría ser estrenada esta semana. Could be out. It's uncertain if. Ah, esto está como mezclando condicional, o sea, nos estamos adelantando un poquito. Sorry. This is not for the next class, okay? Because we have to talk about conditionals to work with this exercise. Okay, my friends, we are going to stop here, okay? Just stop here. The next class, we are going to continue working with these words, the modals to talk about possibilities, okay? Well, thanks for coming. Thanks for your attention.